Greetings of the day. I am Asha K, Assistant Professor, Department of ECE, Sai Vidya Institute of Technology.
Central Processing Unit. These are the key points you all should remember. A 40-bit arithmetic logical unit, a 40-bit accumulator we have, a barrel shifter we are using here, and a multiplier is of size 17 cross 17, and an adder is of size 40-bit, and we have a compare, select, and store unit. And also we have an exponent encoder to adjust the exponent values in case of floating point arithmetic operations. And also we have a data address generation unit and a program address generation unit. And the central processing unit consists of performs arithmetic logical operations on 16-bit data, 32-bit data, and 40-bit data. And we have we can also perform two 16-bit arithmetic and logical operations simultaneously. Instead of having 32-bit or 40-bit, and ALU arithmetic logical unit, which utilizes the accumulator A and B register. Accumulator A and B register are used to store the data, and this accumulator A and B register will have accumulator register lower word, accumulator register higher word, and accumulator register guard bits. Similarly for B, B guard bits, B register of higher word and B register of lower word. And how many bit it will be? 0 to 15, 16 bit. Again, 16 to 31, it is again, you will be having 16 bit of data. And again, 32 to 40, 32 to 39 will be an 8 bits of guard bits. So whenever the more number of storage data we are getting after the multiplication and successive additions in case of multiply and accumulation operations. So in such cases, guard bits will avoid the overflow condition of the accumulator A and B register. And here, these are the symbolic representation of accumulator A and accumulator B register. And later in the last class, we started with learning the central processing unit. And the central processing unit will consist of an arithmetic logical unit. This arithmetic logical unit, so you have to remember here this one, A is accumulator A, B is accumulator B, is temporary register T, and C is data from the data bus, C bus. And again, D is data from the D bus, and S is shifter output. Try to remember, this is A, B, C, T, and T. For central processing unit, we'll be having the arithmetic logical unit along with the one more sub-block. So try to remember this blocks. This is A, B, T, C or A, B, C, T. You can reverse it. It's not a problem. If for your understanding purpose, you can alphabetically order. You can write A, B, C, T also. Otherwise, ma'am will remember like this. We'll write like this, means it is well and good. A, B, T, C, accumulator A, accumulator B, temporary register, and C. D is data bus. S is the shifter output. So what type of shifter we are using here? Barrel shifter. Barrel shifter output is a 40 bit. So automatically what kind of data has to be chosen will be decided by the select lines of the multiplexer. So here one select line is sufficient, but in this case, four inputs are there, two select lines are necessary. So based upon the select line, whether A is selected or B is selected or T is selected or C is selected, so that will be selected, and that is controlled by the sign controller. So this is the sign controller. The sign controller will act upon the value of the SXM, sign extension mode, which is available in the ST1 register. This SXM is one of the bit field in case of status register 1. And we have the inputs which is appearing to the arithmetic and logical unit, that is Y and X are the two inputs. So that later that performs the arithmetic and logical operations on the operands, A, X and Y operands. And here, after performing this arithmetic logical operations, this operations will be based upon the values of this flag bits also. What are all the flag bits that affected or that operation affected is, we have an overflow mode bit. This is present in ST1 register. I hope all my students remember. C C16-bit, that is dual 16-bit addition or double precision arithmetic addition will be performed by using this bit, is whether it is 1 or whether it is 0. And we have a carry flag bit. Whenever we wanted to consider the carry flag for the addition, means that carry flag will be an invert. If any operation results in carry, that carry flag will be set to 1. And we also have overflow for accumulator A and overflow for accumulator B. And we also have 0 accumulator A register or 0 in the accumulator B register. Test bar control bit is there. So this is the test bar control bit, which is also one of the bit which is present in the ST0 register. These three are ST0 register, whereas these three, this is also ST0 register. These two are ST1 register along with the SXM. On the other side, here also you should remember this acronym AMB, AMUB. M is multiplier, U is addition result, that is arithmetic logical unit result. B is accumulator B, A is accumulator A. And we have A register, B register and an accumulator register. So this diagram you have to practice. Then you have to write in the exam. When they ask for 6 to 7 marks question, with a neat functional diagram, explain the central processing unit of TMS32054XX processor. We have a barrel shifter that performs the shifting operation 0 to 31 or 0 to 16 or minus 16 through 15. These are the different types of shifts we can perform. The shift count field of the ST1 register or the temporary register will taken care. The barrel shifter will affect by the ASM, accumulator shift mode bit, that is a 5-bit field of the ST1 register. And this the barrel shifter diagram is shown in figure 3.3. A barrel shifter and along with an exponent encoder normalizes the values in the accumulator in a single machine cycle. So we have here least significant bits. Whenever we are performing that sign extension mode, least significant bits are filled with zeros, and the most significant bits are filled with either zeros or sign extended bit. Sign extended means if the sign bit is 1, means that sign will be extended further. So depending upon the state of sign extension mode, SXM. So depending upon the value of SXM, which is present in status register 1, so this particular operation will be performed. And also we have an additional shift capability that enables the processor to perform numerical scaling, bit extraction, extended arithmetic, overflow prevention operations with the help of this shifting operations, that is barrel shifter. This is the block diagram or the functional diagram of the barrel shifter. In this functional block diagram, remembering it will be easy. Previous diagram, when we have the compare that central processing unit, the central processing unit, you had ABC, T was the temporary register you had, and one more was DS on the other side, another input. D was the data bus and S was the shifter output. So what is the shifter output, ma'am? See here it is there. No, this is the shifter output. This ALU means it is moving towards the ALU. The output of the shifter is connected as in one of the input to the arithmetic logical unit. And this barrel shifter is also taken care by this TC bit, test bit, test bar control bit we had in ST1 register. So that is also taken care as this particular barrel shifting operations. What are the inputs to the barrel shifter? The inputs to the barrel shifters may be an accumulator B 40-bit data or an accumulator A 40-bit data, or two types of buses I can use for reading purpose. That is, one is DB or another one is CB, data bus DB or data bus CB. So these can be used. So this, but these two are of only 16-bit. And we have a sign control bit. So this is the sign control bit, which is in turn controlled or affected by the sign extension mode bit of ST1 register. And here, if you just observe, we have three types of shifting details. ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಬಿಟ್ಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿರುತ್ತೆ? ಮೈನಸ್ 16 to 31 ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಮೈನಸ್ 16 to 31 ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 16, ಮೈನಸ್ 15, ಮೈನಸ್ 14, ಅಪ್ ಟು ಮೈನಸ್ 1. ಎಗೈನ್ 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 15, ಎಗೈನ್ 16, ಅಂಡ್ ಎಗೈನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಟ್ ಇಸ್ 13. ಹೌ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್, ಸಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಿಸ್. This is a T bit temporary register that we have here, T register we have here. That is minus 16 through 31 range we have for this T operations. We have an another bit field called as ASM, accumulator. Are you all there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Accumulator shift mode bit field we have, that is 4 to 0. Minus 16 through 15 range I can perform the shifting operation based upon this accumulator shift bit. The third one, based upon the instruction register immediate, we have minus 16 through 15 or 0 through 15 range. Say for this instruction register, we'll be having only minus 16 through only till 15 range is there. But when it comes to T register or a temporary register, it is we'll be having the data may be from you may have the data from that is minus 16. So I can start from minus 16 through till 31. So till 31 I can perform the shifting operations. But when it comes to accumulator shift mode, again the range is minus 16 through 15 only. When it is with respect to instruction register, it is split into two range. One is minus 16 through 15 plus 15 range, and again from 0 through 15 range. So based upon the application, what type of shifting we want for the data, so these three operations can be performed on the barrel shifter. And the output of the barrel shifter is connected to arithmetic logical unit. And after this arithmetic logical unit, we'll be having the same 40 bit data. See here, most significant word or the least significant word. So ma'am, what is most word anta helidre 16 bit we all know. So in this, we'll be having 0 to 15 and 16 to 32. And also we may have guard bits, extra bits, which are stored to avoid the overflow condition. So here, least significant word or most significant word, write select operation will be performed with the help of EB15 to EB0 data bus. EB15 to EB0 is a data bus. With the help of this data bus, I can transfer the result to the memory. So wherever I want to store this data, so there I can store this particular data operation. See, another one input to the most significant word, least significant word, write select operation is CSSU, compare select store unit. So first one is compare, first S is select, the second S is store, and the last one is unit. Compare, select, store, unit. So this is the entire operation of barrel shifter. And after the barrel shifter, we have a multiplier and adder unit. It's a kernel heart of the DSP processor. And in this multiplier used is 17 cross 17 multiplier. It performs 2's complement multiplication. And also we have an adder unit called as 40-bit addition. That performs the 40-bit addition operations. And along with this, we also have a 16-bit temporary storage register called as T register. And the diagram of multiplier is shown in figure. Multiplier slash adder unit of TMS32054XX processor is shown here. So in this TMS32054XX processor, just observe the inputs to the multiplier. What are the inputs to the multiplier? The inputs to the multiplier are, one is the data from the temporary register, or the data from the data bus, or the data may be from the accumulator A register. It's a 40-bit register. Again, we have here P, A, D, and C. This is TDA, temporary register, D is the data bus, and A is accumulator. Coming to here, we have a program bus that is PB15 to PB0. That may be one of the input, and an accumulator again that may be in one of the inputs. So here, when we performing the accumulation, that is accumulator register, even though it may be of a 40 bit, only 17 bit data we are selecting. So we are not choosing entire 40 bit data. So that will be selected automatically through the programming. And we have here D, another data bus, and C, another data bus. Those can be of the input. Those can be an input to the multiplexer. The multiplexer select lines will decide which one has to be given to the multiplier. And we have again sign control bit with the help of sign extension mode bit. That will be, the sign will be controlled here. Whether sign extension is required or sign extension is not required will be decided by this sign controller controlling logic. And again, the inputs to this multiplier are of 17 cross 17. So the multiplier performs the multiplication. And after the multiplication, what happens? When we perform the multiplication, two sign bits will appear. One sign bit will be neutralized or removed by performing the shift operation. That is with the help of this FRCT bit of SD1 register. If this FRCT is equal to 0, like based upon if it is equal to 1 means automatically this one of the extra sign bit will be neutralized by performing the left shift operation by 1 bit. Otherwise, INT is also there. Sometimes the result may not be fractional value. The result may be an integer type also. If it is an integer type, directly that they transfer that particular data to an adder unit. So one input to the adder unit is multiplier output. Another unit to the adder is the previous stored content in the accumulator. The previous stored content in the accumulator may be present in accumulator A register or accumulator B register. And after performing the, selecting the which accumulator we want, whether it is A, whether it is B, or if it is an initial condition means we'll load the another one input as the zero input. Once in the beginning side, when we start performing the operation, that is multiply and accumulation operation, initially the first input to the adder will be zero. Later, successive additions takes place. When successive addition takes place, during that time, what happens? The output of the adder will be stored again in the accumulator A or B register. So since it is stored in the accumulator A or B register, those previous values will be taken and that will be added along with the new value of the computation. So take an example of your x of k into h of n minus k. Say where this is the value for y of n. Say if I substitute k is equal to, say I'll choose k is equal to 0 to some 7 values I'll choose. And say n is also from 0 to 7 values I'll choose. So if I expand this, what I'm going to get? Y of first value 0, that is equal to x of 0 into your h of minus 0, first term. Again, if I substitute the value of n is equal to 1, so what happens? I'll have, so for k is equal to 1, x of k into h of minus 1 plus x of 2 into h of minus 2. So it goes on. So whenever I don't have the negative values, maybe based upon this first term only, I'll calculate it. So this is nothing but multiplication of the two numbers x and h, and also adding that with the next term. So once multiplication performed, so this the initial input to this will be 0. So that by that time we'll choose this particular 0 bit which is present in this particular block diagram. So this is, see, whenever it is multiplier we call it as xm ym, whenever it is adder we call it as xa and YA. The output of the adder will be stored at the accumulator A or accumulator B register. This adder is also of 40-bit register. The addition of the results will affect the following flag bits of the status register. What are all the flag bits that will be affected, or what kind of the three main important thing is an adder may end up with zero answer, that is zero detect. If there is any zero answer is there, so we have to detect, so based upon the zero detect. And sometimes I need to round off to the next highest number or to the least number. Based upon that, we have round one feature. And we have saturation. We were discussing upon saturation on store bit, which is present in the ST, PMST register. So that the saturation is one of the very important bit. So again, if you just see here to this saturation, whether overflow mode bit has will taken care based upon this value, also the saturation, whether it has happened or not happened, will decide. And also when saturated, when the result is saturated, it has loaded with more than what it can store, means immediately OVA or OV bit will be affected, and ZA or ZB for zero detect, whether zero answer is there in the accumulator A or whether zero answer is there in the accumulator B, that will be decided. So this is about the functional diagram of multiplier and adder unit. So my sincere request, don't confuse with these the inputs. So these are very, very important. So while practicing only, so start practicing this for the first one, what are all the input, that is for first one is central processing unit, the second one is barrel shifter unit, the third one is multiplier and adder unit, and the last one we have is the compare select store unit. So compare select store unit is an hardware unit specifically incorporated to accelerate add, compare and select operations. So add, compare and select operations will be performed with respect to this. So there is an algorithm called as Viterbi algorithm. It's like whenever the data is moving from one node to the other node, whenever the data is digital data is transforming from one mode to the another mode, that you people have learned in CCN classes, that shortest path algorithm. Then you had different kinds of algorithms that you have learned in computer communication networks, right? So here also, this processor, this especially this compare store select unit will perform especially to essential to implement the Viterbi algorithm used in many signal processing applications. So this is one of the thing. And we also have an exponent encoder. This unit's supports the EXP instruction. We have one instruction called as EXP. This exponent encoder that supports the EXP instruction, which stores in temporary register T, the number of leading redundant bits of the accumulator content will be stored with this temporary register. Here, these are the set of memory mapped registers available, MMR anta helbodu, memory mapped registers. These are internal memory mapped registers. Just observe, IMR is interrupt mask register, IFR is interrupt flag register, and hyphen it is not used, reserved for testing, decimal number, hexadecimal number for this. And ST0, hexadecimal place is 6. It is a status register 0. It's a 16-bit register. ST1, we have status register 1, 16-bit register. We have AL, AH, AG. All my students know. Accumulator lower word, accumulator higher word, accumulator guard bit. BL, BH, BG. This is related to accumulator B, lower word, higher word, guard bit. We have a register called as TREG, that is temporary register. You can simply call it as T register. We have another register called as TRN, that is the transition register. Just now in this previous diagram, we had this, right? This is TRN. But in the beginning, when they wrote the textbook and when they took the textbook, they had this TRB. So TRB is nothing but timer reload bit, which resets the on-chip timers of the PMS 32065C54XX processor. When this TRB is set, the TIM, that is timer mode bit, is loaded with the value in the PRD, that is timer period register, and PSC is a timer pre-scalar counter, is loaded with the value in the timer divide down ratio. So whatever the value which is there in TDRR bit, so in that particular bit it will be loaded. Ma'am, what are all those things, ma'am? Again, a timer is a register. In this timer register, we have an operations called as, like bits called as TRB bit, TDRR bit, PRD bit, PSC bit, all those things are there. But from the exam point of view, for our exam point of view, we don't require this timer register understanding. Okay. Don't worry about that. Oh, ma'am, what is that particular bit? Do we need to practice that particular timer register for the exam point of view? Not necessary. Only if you understand this, that much is sufficient. What is this? This is compare, select, store unit. Here, multiplexer we have. The inputs, the multiplexer is accumulator A data or accumulator B data. And afterwards, we'll perform the comparison with the help of a comparator. This is the comparator, COMP. After comparison, what happens? This TRN bit, that is transition register bit, will affect. The transition register will affect. Also, the TC bit, test bar control bit, is also going to affect. Comparison result will be affected, will be like results. The results will be stored in this TRN bit, that is the transition register bit, and also the TC bit, test control bit, which is available in the ST0 register. This is compare, select, and store unit. The output of the comparator, this is comparator comparison unit, which is connected to the most significant word or least significant word, select. Or if you just observe this in the barrel shifter unit, so this was the barrel shifter, the barrel shifter unit, CSSU. The output of the COMP is connected, COMP is connected to most significant word or least significant word, right select. Here, this is the barrel shifter output. Barrel shifter output. So that is shown here, part of that is shown here in the in this circuit. Part of this is shown in this particular circuit. So this is the barrel shifter. Ma'am, in the main architecture diagram, they have used, instead of this, they have used TRN, they have used TRB. So what is this TRB anta heladre? TRB is a timer reload bit. To load the timer, we use this particular bit. It resets the on-chip timers. What is the main purpose? Setting and resetting the on-chip timer is the main purpose of this TRB bit. When TRB bit is set, what is going to happen? The timer mode is loaded with the value which is available in the timer period register. It is one of the register, and the PSC, that is timer pre-scalar counter, will be there, that is loaded with the value of timer divide down ratio. So if you are trying to write TRB, so just remember it is a timer reload bit which is used to reset the on-chip timer. And after completion of the functional architecture, we were discussing about the memory mapped register, internal memory mapped register. In this internal memory mapped register, we have interrupt mask register, interrupt flag register, we have ST0, status register 0, status register 1, accumulator A, accumulator B, then transition, temporary register, transition register, and observe this, auxiliary registers 0 to 7, auxiliary register 0 to 7, 8 different registers we have in this case. And after this, the next one we have is stack pointer. BK is a circular buffer size register. BRC is block repeat counter. Next one is RSA, block repeat start address, block repeat end address. We have PMST, that is processor mode status register. And we have the next one, XPC, extended program page register. And the last one, which is a reserved one, which is not used. If you wanted to address this, these are the hexadecimal location, which is residing on that particular location. 0 means it is internal memory mapped register space for IMR. IMR is interrupt mask register. It will be very easy to remember. It's not that much difficult. If they ask, explain the internal memory mapped register of TMS32054XX processor, you can easily write this. Till now, might be separately, they have not asked any question. So only for your understanding purpose, if you remember this, that is sufficient. And after this, again, I just put the architectural diagram, functional diagram of TMS32054XX. Exponent encoder is here. And this is the multiplier unit. This is the CPU, central processing unit. Multiplier and adder is the kernel of the DSP processor. And this is the central processing unit of the processor. You have a barrel shifter and you have a CSSU, compare, select, store unit. And along with that, we have one program bus, two data bus for read operation, one data bus for write operation. We have a program address generation logic. We have a data address generation logic. And memory and external interface is there. Peripheral interface is there. Memory and external interface is connected through this side. And peripheral interface is connected to this side. And we have a system control and interface of the architecture. And some of this symbolic representation, what and every bit is telling. What is A, what is B, U, S, M, P, T. All those things are given here. We call it as a legend. And one more, peripheral is there, right? Peripheral registers we have. The peripheral registers of the DSP processors are, these are the peripheral registers that we have. PRD, I was just discussing, timer period register. TCR, timer control register. TIM, TIM is timer register. This is with respect to CSSU unit, compare, select, store unit.